Hello, Power Rangers Lightning Collection fans, and welcome to the next chapter of the Lightning Library, the series covering the history and details of every entry in the Lightning Collection, so you know which are the best, what you're getting with each entry, and what I think of them. For years at numerous conventions, specifically San Diego Comic-Con, New York Comic-Con, and Power Morphicon, there have been exclusive products made by Bandai America to be sold at these conventions. During the era of the Legacy figures from 2016 through 2018, most of these exclusives were Legacy figures. The first one of the Legacy figures actually debuted at SDCC 2016, before Wave 1 hit the shelves. Once Hasbro took over and began the Lightning Collection, there was almost no question on whether they would continue this tradition as well. Hasbro was no stranger to making convention exclusives. They did it for all of their other 6-inch figure lines, so it was obvious Power Rangers Lightning Collection would get one as well. Heading into the summer, Wave 1 of Lightning Collection had been out for a few months. Nothing for the line had been announced since New York Toy Fair back in February, until June 10th, 2019, via CNET.com, but the SDCC Lightning Collection exclusive would be announced. Hasbro was to sell their first ever Lightning Collection 2-pack, containing the iconic MMPR character Jason Lee Scott in two of his Ranger forms, the Armored Red Ranger from Season 1 and the Gold Zeo Ranger. Included would be the typical bells and whistles of the Lightning Collection, as well as the complete Power Blaster featuring all of the main power weapons of the MMPR team, two Jason heads, special packaging, and all for the price point of $50. In comparison to Bandai's exclusives, specifically Psycho Green and Psycho Silver, those Legacy figures from the year before cost $45 apiece and didn't come with anything close to what this Hasbro 2-pack would offer. This was a welcome surprise for everything in the set, but fans did have their complaints about the figures themselves, specifically on the helmets. Helmets on Lightning Collection figures have been a point of contention from the very beginning of the line, with SPD Shadows missing paint, and will continue to be a point of discussion in the future. For these two, MMPR Red was missing the white trim on the front of the visor that would typically be there, making it look very off from a straight-on view. Zeo Gold's looked fine from a distance, however it was noticed that the visor on the figure was molded raised off of the helmet, while the in-show suit had it just flush with the smooth surface. Interestingly enough, the set was seen as a continuation of the strive to one-up Bandai from Hasbro, since the Legacy versions of these figures were plagued with problems to the most infamous issue in the Legacy Collection line, the butterscotch dull gold plastic that was used for Zeo Gold's shield, when the prototype for the figure had showed a nice gold metallic paint. Needless to say, Hasbro could fix some of the worst Legacy figures right out of the gate in this 2-pack. San Diego Comic-Con 2019 began on Wednesday, July 17th. As soon as attendees had a chance to pick up their figures, pictures began to surface online of the set, and it was on display at the Hasbro booth alongside Wave 1 in a few mysterious boxes. IGN uploaded a video unboxing of the sets on July 19th, where they mistakenly called Zeo Gold the Zeo Black Ranger. Good one, guys.
The Black Ranger from Power Rangers Zeo, they come with all sorts of accessories and stuff.
Max's packaging is awesome.
Another chance to get the set, especially if you didn't attend SDCC or didn't pay the prices in that month afterward, the set was available on Hasbro Pulse on August 27th, when it was made available for Hasbro Pulse premium members and then for the general public the next day on Power Rangers Day, August 28th. On both days, the set sold out within minutes. Some were lucky, others were not. Since these releases in the US, the set has come out in other countries as well. Hasbro made it an exclusive to conventions around the world, such as Paris Comic-Con and MCM London Comic-Con during October of 2019. In the little over a year since its original release, the price has continued to rise in the aftermarket, and is today one of the most expensive past releases to track down, with prices typically ranging between $150 and $250. Before diving into the figures themselves, being a convention exclusive, a little more care was put into the box for this figure. It features a slipcase cover with new artwork from Tom Whalen, who does the art for the entire Lightning Collection. Cardboard prints of the Red Ranger box were being sold with Austin St. John autographs at SDCC as an additional purchase alongside this figure set, and that makes it a great novelty to go along with the box. Taking off the slipcase reveals a typical Lightning Collection style box, but the first for a 2-pack. two packs, mainly the ones in 2019, featured forward-facing artwork from Tom rather than the profile shot seen on the individual releases, making them stand out more. The SDCC set is also the first to feature a profile for the figures on the back. An interesting thing to note is that the bottom tray the box sits in is slightly different in its international releases from its US release. The international releases had more writing and warnings present on it in comparison to the US release. Looking at the figures themselves, we'll start with Armored Red. This is the first figure released to use this mold of a male MMPR Ranger wearing the Dragon Shield, and would certainly not be the last. This was one of the first figures released that was sculpted by Dennis, or at Always Bumping on Twitter as well, which is neat to see. As with every Lightning Collection figure, Jason has the typical articulation points, which are featured on this chart for a reminder and breakdown here. The helmet is the elephant in the room. Compared to the helmet from the show, the MMPR Red looks quite off in every release Hasbro has done, due to the missing paint in the middle of the visor. It makes the figure look incomplete from a straight angle, but good from the side, however. The belt is a bit flawed as well, as it does not feature a gold-painted morpher like this form should. Accessories-wise, Jason is fully armed. He has the blade blaster in its blaster mode and holstered mode, which the holstered version of would not come in the normal wave releases of the MMPR Rangers. He has the dragon dagger and the complete power blaster with all five MMPR power weapons. The power blaster can separate into these individual weapons, and the power axe can even swap from axe to blaster mode. These weapons were the same as the versions that would be released later in the individual MMPR releases. Jason comes with two holding hands and two fists. Pretty basic, but it gets the job done. Finally, Jason comes with a smiling Jason head, which here it is compared with Season 1 Austin St. John. Continuing the classic issue with Lightning Collection swords, the Power Sword is extremely prone to paint chips and smears, with the black paint rubbing off into the white gloves being very common. This also makes it very difficult to keep swapping between Power Blaster mode and Individual Weapon mode, since that also causes the paint to smear. Moving on to Zeo Gold, he is the real star of this set. Jason in this Ranger form once again features the same articulation points. His shield actually has gold paint on it compared to Bandai's Legacy version, which was greatly appreciated. A short while after the set was released, @dano_tokunation on Twitter had noticed that under the shield, Zeo Gold has the moldings on his chest and butterfly joints for the normal male Zeo Rangers, which seemed to confirm that they would be seen in the line sooner rather than later. Zeo Gold comes with the exact same hands that Armored Red did. Weapons-wise, he has the closed and open version of his iconic Golden Power Staff, both versions of which stayed exclusive to this set, following a third version of the staff being released during the Wave 5 re-release of this figure. Jason has an orangish-slash-golden effect piece, which is the same one from Wave 1's Lord Zed, but in a new color, making this the first reused effect piece in the line. Finally, the Jason head features a more stern and static expression in comparison with Armored Red. The extra accessories and fancier box is what brought the convention-level charm to this release, and was released in perfect timing with the announcement made at SDCC 2019 of Austin St. John returning to the franchise in Power Rangers Beast Morphers. SDCC would not just have this announcement, though. The SDCC set was on display alongside three mysterious boxes at the Hasbro booth, and next time in the Lightning Library, we'll take a look at what was in some of these as we cover Lightning Collection Wave 2.